morning, one and all, and a very warm welcome to Rotherham Minster, and happy Easter to each and every one of you. Before we begin properly, it's been a while since we've gathered for a Sunday service. We know that because I was stood with the verger at 9 o'clock this morning going, now what do we need for a service? So forgive me if you can remember everything crystal clear, but I'm going to just run through some of the practicalities for the way that we need to operate in order to keep one another safe. So there are a few things. Generally, please follow the directions of the stewards, because hopefully they will know slightly better than you how to do it. For most of the service, please remain where you are. When we come to communion, if you'd be willing to be as guided by the stewards, you come out into the side aisles. As you come forward to receive, there is gel on the front pews for you to take some off, and then you will receive communion either here or there, depending on which side you come up, and then you go back down the central aisle and back into your pews, and it all looks seamless, I promise. So please remember to use the gel as you come forward. If you don't want to receive communion but simply want a blessing, still come round. And even if you don't want either, can I respectfully ask you to go with the flow at that point, because we will need everybody to move in order to make sure that we can all get back into our respective places safely. At the end of the service, our final hymn, which we'll be allowed to sing, will be outside in the churchyard. So again, the stewards will invite you row by row to go out. Please remember, you are going out, so take all of your belongings with you. It's the end of the service in that sense. And that when we're outside, we'll gather in the churchyard and we're going to sing our closing hymn, and then there'll be a blessing before we're all able to disperse from there. So general rule of thumb, please follow the guidance of the directions of the stewards. As you leave, please would you keep these with you, so that it's another way that we can avoid transmission risk and take them home and dispose of them accordingly. And there will be a retiring collection, so if you haven't noticed the collection plate on your way in, then please feel free to contribute to the life of God's work through this place on the way out. I must remind you that we're not allowed to sing in here, but we've got one or two creative things up our sleeves anyway. It's so lovely to see you. It's so lovely to be back. And we'll formally welcome all the other people that will be joining us online once we've started properly. Let's just take a moment in quiet before we begin.
Christ yesterday and today,
Christ our Lord, guide us and keep us. Amen. So good morning and a very warm welcome to all of you that are gathered here in Rotherham Minster and to any joining us online as we begin our joyful Easter celebration. This is the day when our Lord Jesus Christ passed from death to life. Throughout the world, Christians celebrate the awesome power of God. As we hear his word and proclaim all that God has done, we can be confident that we shall share his victory over death and live with him forever. May the light of Christ, rising in glory, banish all darkness from our hearts and minds. The light of Christ. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Now you're warming up. Are you ready? Alleluia. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Jesus Christ, risen Lord, we come to you to say sorry for our sins and to confess to you our weakness and unbelief. Like Mary at the empty tomb, we fail to understand the wonder of your presence. Lord, have mercy. We are sorry. Like the disciples behind locked doors, we are afraid to be known as your followers. Lord, have mercy. We are sorry. Like Thomas in the upper room, we are slow to believe. Lord, have mercy. We are sorry. May Almighty God, who sent his Son into the world to save sinners, bring you his pardon and peace, now and forever. Amen. So please would you stand. Now unfortunately we can't invite you to sing, but by the wonders of modern technology we can listen to others singing and join in. So there are some actions to join in with this song, which go like this. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way. From the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. So it's going to start, and I'll do the actions through the first time, and if you want to have a little practice, feel free, and then join in properly from the second time through. With faith and hope, for a new day has dawned, and the way to life stands open. In our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. We remain standing for our Gospel reading. Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Alleluia. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them,
They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him.
Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrap.
wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them,
"They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him."
When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him,
"Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away."
Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew,
"Rabboni,"
which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God.'" Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples,
"I have seen the Lord."
And she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
I have the crucified, cross-bound. but not for long, just warning you. It is lovely to see you this morning, and if you hadn't already guessed, this is an all-age service, which means that it's very interactive. So I hope you've got your bags. You're not going to need them yet. Has anyone eaten their chocolate? Oh, the speaker's pointed over there. Okay, never mind. You will be able to go anyway. And if you haven't got a bag, I apologise. We're going to need our service books for this bit, our service sheets. It was a sad day. Jesus was on the cross. There were prisoners on two crosses, one on the left, one on the right. Jesus looked down and saw his mum Mary and one of his special friends, John. John, please take care of my mum for me. Jesus looked right. One of the prisoners on the cross had started to make fun of Jesus. Aren't you God's son? Then save yourselves and save us too. Jesus looks left. The other prisoner said, hang on, we're being punished for the things we have done wrong. But Jesus has done nothing wrong. Jesus, remember me when you get to heaven. Jesus answered, today we will be there together. Jesus looked ahead at the soldiers. Father, forgive those who have put me on the cross. They don't understand what they're doing. Jesus looked up. Father, I give you my life. And he died. It was the happiest of days. The soldiers were asleep. Mary and his friends went to the place where body lay. They wanted it to smell nice. There were some sniffs over there. Brilliant. But where was the big, heavy stone? Someone had rolled it away. Rolled. They went inside. They gasped. Someone was a bit early. Jesus' body isn't here. It's gone. He's gone. Then they saw an angel and were very afraid. Don't be afraid, said the angel. I know you are looking for Jesus. God has brought him alive again, just as Jesus said he would. The women were amazed. Can I see some amazed faces over there, Cheeseman? Brilliant, perfect. They turned and started to run. Then Jesus met them and said, good morning.
Morning.
Morning. He told them to go and tell everyone that he was alive again. He is alive. Wonderful acting there. You can take a seat while I just get my props. Now for this bit, those of you that have chocolate and haven't eaten them will need them. Mine's a bit bigger, I'm sorry. But you needed to see it. Okay. So the closed egg, if we can get our eggs out, is like the tomb where Jesus' friends put his body after he had died. I wonder how they felt when they were left all on their own. It's sad, isn't it, when friends go away or someone who we know dies? Let's just pause for a moment and think of someone we know who is sad, upset, or lonely. Father God, we pray that you'll be close to all people who are lonely this Easter time. This egg is like a tomb because it's dark and cramped. But when Jesus died, as we've just found out, it was not the end of the story. The resurrection had happened. Jesus burst out of the tomb. Now, he wasn't like a zombie that you might see on some computer games or horror film. But he burst out with an awesome power that moved a huge stone. So on Good Friday, sorry, I have to wear a bit of protection for this. Death was smashed once and for all, and there was no going back. The resurrection had undoubtedly happened. Let's just take a moment to eat our eggs and thank Jesus for his power and his resurrection. New life, being set free. Death has lost its sting. Jesus is the first of the resurrection. Corinthians says, if there is no resurrection of the dead, then Christ has not been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, then your faith is useless and you're still guilty of your sins. In that case, all who have died believing in Christ are lost. And if our hope in Christ is only for this life, then we are more to be pitied than anyone in the world. But in fact, Christ has risen from the dead. He is the first of the great harvest of all who died. There in the garden, the resurrection had already happened. But Mary didn't know yet. She was trapped in her own Good Friday. Her grief and sadness kept her in the dark. And we can tell that exact moment when the resurrection happened for her. It was when Jesus called her name, Mary. Suddenly, grief is turned to joy. Mary's Good Friday is smashed once and for all. The new life she has set her free. You may eat your second chocolate, if you've finished your first. Mary, the apostle to the apostles, a most unlikely witness. She was there when Jesus was crucified, and she remained steadfast and faithful, right until the very end. She was the first to see him alive, even though women's testimonies at that time held no weight. Still, he asked Mary to go and tell his disciples that he was alive. Because there's a danger, isn't there, that we can allow our minds to be trapped in Good Friday thinking and not open our minds to the resurrected Jesus, the powerful Lord who changed history and who can change all our lives. In the resurrected Christ, we can have a fresh start, a new beginning. And we will be with him in eternity, for the temple curtain has been torn in two. We can be with the one who loves us with that unconditional, never giving up love. And one day, there will be a renewed heaven and a renewed earth. And we will be with God. Now you might notice in your bag there's another egg. Don't eat this one. Just warning you. And there are little bits if we've got anybody under three. But we thought it would be nice for you to decorate your own egg to take home with you. Now, Phil said it was to be like a Fabergé egg, is that right?
That's what I'm shooting for.
That's what he's shooting for. See if you can beat that. They're just going to, the organ's going to play and just spend some time decorating your eggs.
Sally, mine's not quite Fabergé quality, but it's under construction.
Please would you stand? Let us declare our faith in God. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated for our intercessions.
As we celebrate the new life of resurrection, let us pray to the one true God who brings the promise of eternal life to us all. We pray for our churches throughout the world, especially those that today still stand empty, but like the empty tomb, are alive in the body of our risen Lord and in every home that worships him today. We ask God's blessing on our own churches, the Minster and St. Paul's, and celebrate being able to return on this Easter morning. Thanks to all our clergy and all who have worked to keep our worship alive and vibrant through these difficult times, and keeping us connected as family, community, and church.
We pray for all other Christians rejoicing today in the wonder of resurrection. May your resurrection light lead us.
Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray for everyone in our global family who is affected by the COVID pandemic, for those in our own community, and for those who live in countries where healthcare is limited and poverty brings enormous challenges. May you grant us all the gift of an open-hearted, generous, and compassionate response to those in need.
We ask for your blessing and loving care for all those who work to help and look after others. Be with them, Lord, in the loving and caring work they do. May your resurrection light lead us.
Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Lord God, we bring before you the hopes and fears of our own community, our families and friends, that you may bless our lives and give us all strength and inspiration for what lies ahead. We pray that through these uncertain times, you will continue to be our rock.
Lord God, we thank you for the gift of new life. May we never again take it for granted, but live in the fullness of life that Jesus has gained for us. May your resurrection light lead us.
Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Lord God, we give you thanks for your loving mercy shown to us in Jesus Christ, who endured the suffering on the cross to overcome all that separates us from you and was raised up to new life. Bring healing and comfort to all those who are anxious, upset, lonely or ill. May all who suffer be led from pain to peace. We pray for those we know personally to be in need and who we name silently in our hearts.
We thank you that you are forgiving God who wipes out all wrongs from the past and starts anew with us today. May your resurrection light lead us.
Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
With the words of resurrection fresh in our hearts and minds, we commend to your eternal love those many thousands who have died of all nationalities and beliefs, that they may all live with our risen Lord in your kingdom forever. We especially remember today Reverend Brian Pritchard and pray for his wife and two children who survive him.
We commend them all to your eternal love that they may live within you forever. May your resurrection light lead us.
Lord, in your mercy. Lord, the resurrection of your Son has given us new life and renewed hope. Grant us wisdom to know what we must do, the will to want to do it, the courage to undertake it, the perseverance to continue to do it, and the strength to complete it.
God of promise and God of hope, we praise your wonderful name. May your resurrection lead us.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
So whilst we have to remain in our places, let's wish one another God's peace and even a happy Easter. Please be seated as the table is prepared. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is always right to give you thanks, God our Creator, loving and faithful, holy and strong. You made us and the whole universe and filled your world with life. You sent your Son to live among us, Jesus our Saviour, Mary's child. He suffered on the cross. He died to save us from our sins. He rose in glory from the dead. You send your Spirit to bring new life to the world and clothe us with power from on high. And so we join the angels to celebrate and sing. Thank you. Father, on the night before he died, Jesus shared a meal with his friends. He took the bread and thanked you. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this to remember me." After the meal, Jesus took the cup of wine. He thanked you and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood, the new promise of God's unfailing love. Do this to remember me." Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Father, as we bring this bread and wine and remember his death and resurrection, send your Holy Spirit that we who share these gifts may be fed by Christ's body and his blood. Pour your Spirit on us that we may love one another, work for the healing of the earth, and share the good news of Jesus as we wait for his coming in glory. For honour and praise belong to you, Father, with Jesus, your Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Believing the promises of God as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we share in one bread. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Jesus Christ is holy. Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Let us pray. God of life, who for our redemption gave your only begotten Son to the death of the cross, and by his glorious resurrection have delivered us from the power of our enemy, grant us so to die daily to sin, that we may evermore live with him in the joy of his risen life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So a reminder that our service will conclude in the churchyard. If I can encourage you to maintain social distancing, but stay in your household bubbles, that's absolutely fine, but maintain social distancing from one another. Please take all of your belongings with you. If you haven't received the newsletter by email, there are hard copies available that you should be able to grab on your way out. And please take your orders of service with you. That will just help with us being able to dispose of those safely.